Duluth WeatherMax forecast with meteorologist Dave Anderson.
Well, the cold snap is here, and here are some of the low temperatures we woke up to this morning. In Minnesota, got as cool as only 9 above for Big Fork, 11 for Hibbing, 17 for the Twin Ports here was one of the warmer places. Swinging into Wisconsin and the UP, mid to upper teens there. And we're looking for round two tonight into tomorrow morning. The cold snap, like I mentioned, is here, and it will stay around for a few days. Maybe a small break for the weekend, and then really come back by Veterans Day. Marine Corps birthday into Veterans Day. Next round of the cold snap really starts to click its fingers here in our area. But now we head up to the airport in Duluth to check out the current conditions. Where right now the sky is clear, but with a low pressure system trying to advance up and over our high pressure system, we actually could cloud up for a few hours tonight. Temperature right now is 23. The wind is westerly, northwesterly, 7 miles per hour. Relative humidity relatively low at 46%. And our air pressure is high at 30.26 because of the surface high pressure system that has come our way from the northwest. Temperatures at this hour, a little bit brisk, to be polite. 16 for Ely, 18 Hibbing, 21 Grand Rapids, and 18 International Falls. Eyeing up 16 right now towards Silver Bay in Finland. Low to mid-20s for many communities here at the head of the lakes. 23 right now, Moose Lake and Solon Springs and Superior. And then teens from the Upper Peninsula towards Ashland and the Bayfield Peninsula. Again, low temps tonight, probably in the teens. High temps tomorrow, another round in the 20s. Now, with the high pressure in place for the most part, I think it's going to be dry except for a few flurries for some towns. One exception, though, could be from the Keweenaw Peninsula through the eastern parts of the UP, where lake effect could kick in. Folks here are facing a winter weather advisory. But for the rest of us, yeah, with the high pressure in place and the low to our west, we're probably going to get more clouds than anything else, at least for right now. Better chance for light snow could come around for the weekend, and even that chance isn't fantastic. So Arctic high pressure has made us chilly. We will stay that way probably through Friday and maybe into parts of Saturday. But come Saturday, this low pressure system should bring a light snow chance to the region. Maybe not much more than flurries. So if you're getting out for Minnesota deer opener Saturday, probably not enough for tracking snow, but hopefully cool enough where you can maneuver through the woods without sinking into the bogs, which happens sometimes, especially around the cotton area. Tonight in Minnesota, low temps will go from the teens inland to about 20 right by the lake. In Wisconsin and Michigan, low temps there, mid to upper teens, mostly cloudy for most towns. UP could have some of those Keweenaw Peninsula snow showers backtrack towards places like Bessemer, Wakefield, and Ironwood. Tomorrow, Wisconsin, Michigan starts cloudy in the morning, becomes partly cloudy in the afternoon, but those UP lake effect snow showers could continue through much of the day. Minnesota, high temps, mid-20s, partly cloudy during the day, border flurries possible at night. Now here's the extended forecast, my friends. The weekend, it gets as warm as 35. That's about all she wrote for the week ahead. Otherwise, yeah, the next round of the cold snap does hit on Monday. Low temps down into the single digits if this morning wasn't cool enough for you.
All right. Well, here we are.
Here we are.
Thanks, Dave. Mm-hmm.